I'm Andrew Lear. I'm an expert on LGBTQ plus history and art. I'm a retired professor of classics with a research specialty in same-sex relations in ancient Greek culture, especially in art and poetry. And I've published a book about that and many articles and encyclopedia listings and so on. In retirement, I founded two companies, a for-profit company called Oscar Wilde Tours. That is the first and only tour company focused on LGBTQ plus history and culture, and a nonprofit called We Were There that does educational projects about similar themes. I've worked both as an expert and as a presenter. As an expert, I've designed trails on LGBTQ plus history in several art museums, and I'm developing a TV series on LGBTQ plus history with author and actor Stephen Fry, which has been greenlighted by the BBC, although not yet produced. If I'm going to tell you a story, I could tell you about Antinous, whom you can see on this book cover. Antinous is a person you see a lot in art museums. In fact, he's one of the foremost represented people from classical antiquity, along with Julius Caesar, Augustus Caesar, and Hadrian, who are much more important than he was. So it's an interesting situation. What Antinous was Hadrian's lover. We don't know much about his life or about their relationship. He was a good-looking young man, or at least he's represented as a good-looking young man with fabulous hair and a kind of sulky stare and big pouty lips, very much like an Armani model. But what's interesting about the Antinous story doesn't start until he died. In 130 AD, at about the age of 19, Antinous drowned in the Nile. We don't know what happened. He probably fell, or perhaps he jumped, which is actually what I believe. But what's interesting is what happened next, which is that Hadrian had him declared a god. Now, you might think that happened all the time in the ancient world, but no. Emperors were declared gods when they died. Some empresses as well. No other kept boy was ever declared a god. But it was super successful. That's why we have 150 statues and busts of him. He was worshipped throughout the Roman Empire for several hundred years. In fact, I think he had an important role in late Roman religion. So people often ask, what was Antinous the god of? Well, he wasn't the god of anything. He was a kind of junior god. If you were intimidated by the big gods like Jupiter or Juno, you could pray to Antinous and he would intercede for you with them. Does that remind you of anyone? In Christianity too, there is a junior god, a son of God, who, quote, makes intercession for us, end quote. So I think that Hadrian deified Antinous so there would be a warm, cuddly god whom people could worship if they were tempted to become Christians, but without getting in trouble. So anyway, that's the kind of fun LGBTQ plus history or story that you can learn from my lectures, TV series, tours, etc.